Hello everyone and welcome back to HippoCrisis Gaming. My name is Dan and this is Pokémon Sun. So in the last episode we took on some trainers and then the Dragonium Z trial. If you didn't catch it, you can click on the eye up there and catch up. So we're heading north further into this cave. I've just come out of here to fly to the Pokémon Center, but as it turns out Lily can still heal me, so that saved me a little bit of hassle. So this is the cave where we did the trial. I'm just going to run through it, I guess. I'm not sure if there are any wild Pokemon here now the trial's over. I also need to sniff around this bit for any hidden item. There's got to be something in here, I think, but when I say got to be, if there isn't, then obviously I'm wrong. Should be, is my... But then again, every time I find something, it's what? It's a mushroom, it's a pearl, it's a like X defense, which I don't use, so... Yes, so I just checked that the last episode recorded before I, okay. Oh, yeah, that's why we're here. We're trying to summon Solgaleo. I've forgotten all about that. Oh, and Hapu's here as well. Yeah, I just checked it recording. For some reason, like, it dropped the last 15 seconds of my outro. And I think I've seen it cut off the last couple of words before. But it's never been too much of a problem. But that was really annoying. But I wasn't going to re-record the whole thing just for that, so, if you noticed and you were like, oh, this guy's really unprofessional, I did press stop recording after I finished talking, I promise. Anyway. Oh, so she's healing me again anyway. Oh, every time I heal, even though this time it didn't put me out, she heals me again. Right, so hopefully I've got some balls, because I'm imagining I have to catch Solgaleo, unless... Well, we'll find out. I'm a bit confused, to be honest, because I happen to... Okay, let's check this area for items, just to be very anticlimactic. Why does Stoutland have to make the noise that a pig would make? Anyway, okay, let's run upstairs. I don't care if there's a hidden item on the stairs. I also don't care if I can use the, these are the type of stairs that a, like, and then a giant flying Pokemon blasts through the stairs. Okay, there's got to be something hidden here. Or the other side. Again, only has to be if there is. If I'm wrong, then obviously I'm wrong. Nope, I'm wrong. Okay. Determined to be right at some point. Okay. Please throw me off the dog. I don't want a cutscene where I'm wearing that horrible clothes. Yes. Okay, so I can feel the strong power of the sun, but it's nighttime. That's confusing. I'm going to make my mother wake up and see the reason before I send you back to your old world. I'm going to make her hear me. Is she asleep or is she trapped in the Ultra Beast slit, though? Moon flute. I know it's sort of like wake up and smell the roses, but anyway, so she's gonna toot on her flute. If this is the altar of the sun, though, why is there a moon symbol? Did the altar of the moon have a sun symbol? I don't remember that having that. Okay, so oh, it's where you play the flute. Fair enough. Fine, fine. We all know I don't pay attention. If this is your first video on my channel, one, hello, welcome, don't forget to subscribe, and two, I don't pay attention, that's my way of playing. So, you might remember two or so episodes ago when I said, oh, I forgot to pour myself a drink before I recorded this, still haven't. So, will I blow the sun flute? Yes, I will. I was going to say no, I'll pause and take a drink, but I won't. Because this will be the one time that I forget to unpause and I'm sat talking to myself for 40 minutes. Okay, so it somehow made it daytime. Or did she say, like, let's stand here until the sun comes out? Again, not paying attention. I'm glad that I wore orange because I match my flute. Ooh, okay. Uh-huh. So is this going to actually summon, like, both legendaries, or Solgaleo, or is it going to be a twist? Because I've been wondering for a while if this is like Pokémon Black and White, where actually both legendaries are in the game. I don't know the spoilers for this. This is quite exciting. Oh, Nebby's in the bag. He's woken up, has he? Or is just the bag flying off? No, I think that's not a very natural thing for wind to rip. So it looks like we're just going to get Solgaleo. Because, while I said I don't know spoilers, I do know that Nebby is the legendary off the box. But what does confuse me a little bit is that, not confuse me, but how does one get Nebby for one's Pokédex? If you can only have... Because presumably you can't breed it. So if I never have the other two, how does one get Cosmog? Because I assumed I'd be just given Nebby and then I'd have to train it up. It's weird that she's calling in Nebby still. Anyway, I never imagined that sounding the flutes would give you so much power, or let you evolve into the legendary Pokémon. Laleo! Not in all of my reading, never did I ever come across a hint that you would evolve into a legendary Pokémon. Drink! please, Solgaleo. Or is it Solgaleo? Nebby, please, I need to see my mother. La Liona. It's weird how they have these strange sayings. He's pretty cool, though. I like lions, and I like you. I think, definitely, in regard to... what was it called? Pyroar. Like, Pyroar was... Oh, that's cool. Now do I get him as a right pager? Is this Sunsteel Strike, his move, or is this just him running at a wall? Oh, have we gone into the Ultra Worm hole? World? Ultra World! Oh, this is a nice twist. I don't know why I... To be honest, like... Probably if I was paying attention, I'd know that this was the aim of the... Ultra Space, that's what it's called. The aim of the mission, but that's fine. So, I guess there aren't going to be Ultra Beasts here because they're all in the... they're all fighting the things, right? Or are they here? I'm not sure. We'll find out. I like how I are you scared? No, I'm not scared, because I'm a brave girl now. Now Nebby evolved, I can do anything! Except for leave me alone, apparently. La 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 la, you know, what is it? I don't like him glowing like yellow. That is also a bit like Reshiram and Zekrom, where in the fights they like pulsate and it's weird. Whereas the opposite is the true of Xerneas and Yveltal, who have their appearance on the box with like the glowing colourful crystals only happen in battle. Can I talk to Nebby? Okay, that just takes me through, okay. So I don't know if there's going to be wild Pokemon here, I imagine not. Oh, Guzma! It's your boy! Sitting in a tree! K-I-S-S-I-N-G. I'm the team boss, team school boss, and I've never been scared of nothing or nobody. Heck, I live my life making people scared of me. So listen to what Big Guzma has to say. Y'all are stupid, so please go away, Lily. See, he's on my side. How in the world did you even get to this place? I've got no idea how you did it, but here you are. I preferred it when it was rapping, because this is more difficult to read. It's all dark. I thought it was all dank here then. It's all dank here, yo. Right, okay. Is he wearing a hat? Because this was the thing I'd forgotten. Because I had said, like, he looked about 40 because he's got grey hair, but then I realised maybe it's, like, Brendan from Hoenn situation. Because he has got black sideburns, but I think maybe he's just, like, hip and he's dyed his hair silver like kids do these days. Oh, look! Oh, there's loads of them! I thought there was just one, but I don't know why I thought there was just... Oh, is it a... No, there might just be one. And it's doing a... It's doing a trick. Was that a flashback? Okay, so now he is the lily jellyfish creature. and now he's scared. And okay, I may be the team school boss, but I've never been scared of nothing or nobody. But that lady, she's on a level. She's way far gone. She's lost her mind over these ultra beasts. There's no talking to her, no reasoning with her. She's just gone. What's weird about the ultra beasts is like, how do you reckon in future games they're gonna appear as wild Pokemon, or are they just gonna be like event legendaries? You know, like every now and again they'll give them out. Because it's quite in. Oh, there. Look, there's I don't know its name other than Lily Jellyfish, which is what I've been calling it. Jellily. Not to be confused with that comedian whose, like, surname is Jellily. So all the ghosts are combining into one pile of ghosts, and then they're fleeing, leaving behind only the bottom one, who is also Lusamine. She's like the Cheshire Twat, isn't she? This is a world where the only thing, I thought that said Nintendo, the only thing that exists is a love between Nintendo and myself. That's right. It's every fanboy's wet dream. It's Lusamine, and something that looks like her daughter, who she loves more than her daughter. Now I get why it looks like Lily. And maybe that's why she dressed Lily like that. Who told you that you could come here to the perfect, beautiful world of my beasts and me? Think about what you're saying. What about Mr. Guzma? Don't you care what happens to him? The answer is no. Poor Guzma, who may be 40, maybe 14. Just leave. I don't need you here. Testify! Preach into the choir. I don't need you any longer. I have you in jellyfish form! This is not a beautiful world, though. It looks horrible. It looks like those, like oil slick things, you know, when things look like an oil slick, and you can move it around the light and it goes like pink and blue, and it's the oil slick universe. Anyway, it's just like it was back at the Aether Paradise, only thinking of yourself and what you want. What? And why shouldn't I? Or why shouldn't I? I can live here in a world filled with only things that I love, and I will live here. Dialogue. Oh, she's on her feet. I don't care if you are my child or not. I don't care if you were loyal to me or not. I can't remember her voice. I did have a voice for her. I don't care if you're the rarest Pokemon there and is in the world or not. If you're not beautiful enough to be worthy of my love, then I don't need you. I don't need no man, I don't need no kids, I just need my gang of jellyfish Pokemon. That's alright, all I need to exist in my world are the things that I have with me. Everything else is just a bother to me. That's right. Lily is a bother. Again, preaching to the choir. I'm the one who's sick of you, mother. Children are not just things that belong to their parents. Pokemon are not just things that a trainer can do whatever they want to. I am alive! Cosmog is alive! Well, he's Solgaleo now, but whatever. We are not things for you to collect. If she just said Nebby, it would have made more sense. We're not made for you to just discard when you get bored with us. That's terrible, Mother! You are terrible! Heh! Terrible? Me? How am I different from any other Pokemon trainer? Like your little friend there. True. What do you do with a Pokemon you can't use? You remove it from your party as you please. Enough with this useless. Actually, I send it to Pokemon Pelago to work for me in the mines, so you're wrong. I will never forgive you for stealing Cosmog from me. Never! Back when you were small, you would listen to everything I said without question. For a time, even when you were adorable to me. But you change, you become ugly. Ever since you met this boy Hippo. Don't blame me! Actually, she is quite defiant, because I've been trying to tell her to go away and she hasn't been. So, I don't think it's my fault, but anyway. How dare you intrude upon this world that was meant for Nihilego and me? It's not to be born. And with Nihilego's power, I will show you. I prefer Nintendo. I will show you how wrong you were to come here. Meep, 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 said Nintendo. Why is my nose always itchy? Okay. Do we get to fight Nintendo or Lusamine or anything? No.
I need scratch my nose. I do apologise. Oh,
is that the So that's the one she's caught. That's a new Pokeball they've been working on. And then she's going to wear it as a frock. Oh gosh. Okay. Okay. This is scary. I didn't know this happened. I've never seen this form of Nintendo. Or maybe it's Lusamine's form, to be honest. She looks like a Kingdom Hearts boss now. Not necessarily a bad thing. Now that's thumbnail material if I've ever seen one, but I'm not sure if... Aether President Lusamine. Oh, so she... That's her form, and then she has Clefable. So, six Pokemon. Oh, and their totem. Their totem level. Okay. This is fairy, right? I'm underleveled again. Great. Let's use Acid Downpour, Salazzle. Now, I don't think this is her strongest Pokemon, so blowing my cherry on her first one could be a mistake. But I feel like I need to send a message and do a one bang for the beginning, so I'm basically just fighting four of them. Okay, please one bang. Piddle your acid all over him. Oh no, it's barely touched it. It is super effective, so at least I'm not wrong about that. Right, what else have I got that's good against fairy? Not much. I might be better toxicking and trying to Venoshock. Ooh. That was not a good start. Come on, come on. Withstand, withstand. Don't heal, don't heal. I thought... I'm confusing Moonlight with Moonblast. Do forgive me, children. Children. Right, go. Venoshock. Oh, I am outspeeding, actually. Oh, that's trash. And that's super... Oh, no. Fire move. Don't know if I'll withstand that. Like, as in, like, not very effective. It is, okay. Now, I can't remember what other Pokemon she had. I feel like she might be a fairy trainer, actually. But let's just see. Oh, no! The plague of last episode. At least it's not very good when Clefable does it. I guess Clefable's stats are all in its defense, because it is being very, very hardy right now. What else have I got that could be good against it? I don't need no man animation. I feel a bit locked into Venoshock, actually. I'm really not sure what else I've got. What's good against fairy? Oh, this is Trumbeak using Roost all over again. Well, I guess it doesn't hurt to go through my Pokemon. So, Venoshock is super effective. Heavy Slam, that's the other thing I've got, is Steel. But I just don't feel like Mudsdale's going to be any better than Salazzle right now. Okay, let's use one more Venoshock. And see if she... If I survive this Metronome, I'll heal. What Shuriken, I'm weak to this. Crap. I think it's 2 to 5 times this hits. It was 2. Okay, so we're going to heal up now. The lag is real. I wonder... Do you know what's weird? The last trial that we did... Oh, it's the only hyper potion I've got as well. The last trial I did, you couldn't throw a Pokeball because it was banned within the trial site, even though there was literally nobody around to police it. Meanwhile, in this battle, I can use a Pokeball even though it won't work because it's a trainer. That's weird. Look, I can press Y. Okay, so let's just Venoshock again then. Sorry that this is boring, but I definitely picked a good episode to be on a Sunday. Oh, right, okay. They can't all be annoying as Clefable in before they're all Clefable. So, I can't believe, though, I blew my load on the Z-move for this. Would have been amazing to have Steelium Z on Mudsdale for this, I guess, even though it's not Stab, so... Right, I've only got one more Venoshock left after this. So I'm going to have to switch to a different type of move. I don't know if she's normal fairy, but... Wait. Stat changes. Not stat. Stats in general. That'd be a weird thing to do. Okay, so I'm out of Venoshocks. But this shouldn't be very effective. So that's at least fine. Now, do I try a fire move? I guess I should. I always think that fairy's good against fire, but I think it's the... I think maybe fire resists fairy, but it's not very... because it's just normally effective. So that's the only other move, because dragon doesn't affect fairy, so we're just going to have to... Oh, look at that. See? You see how good that Venoshock was? I guess I... Right, I'm going to have to switch. I'm going to have to go Mudsdale, because... he has physical attacks, and it might be that the special defense on Clefable is sky high. Because I'm not a I'm not a competitive player, I don't know all the Pokemon's stats and things. I only really started paying attention to natures and things properly in Gen 6. And I've not really properly, or at least I escaped that, I've not even properly bothered with that in this series. I've just been focused on genders and that's it. So let's, Okay, I just clearly should have gone with a physical attack. That's completely my bad. Whew. Now, as long as he withstands this. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, that was me being daft. Should have tried that a lot sooner. But we've got a level on Salazzle, so that's fun at least. Okay, Lilligant. Lilligant is pure grass as far as I know. Could be grass fairy, and she could be a fairy trainer, but I think we've got pure grass. So let's go back to Salazzle, and let's go Flamethrower. And then we have the backup with Trumbeak if we need him. No, not Trumbeak. I was going to call him Trumbeak still. It's like it's his name rather than his species designation. Okay, so the old confusion tactic. What is his name? Toucannon. Who I don't really feel like looks like evolves from Pikipek, if I'm completely honest. But unlike Piddove to Unpheasant, who actually do look like they come from each other but are completely different birds, I actually do like Trumbeak, so there is that. Okay. This is going a lot better now, even though I am confused. I have been seeded though, so I have to watch that because that is going to affect every Pokemon. So when I send out Primarina and Mudsdale, it will be super effective. And I'm not sure if you can get rid of the seeds in any way or if they just stay till the end, but that's fine. Let's try. I should have. Oh, right. Okay. Let's just hope we don't hit ourselves in confusion. Good. Should have healed up really there. Even though I've only got crappy potions now. That was one flaw of not going to the Pokemon Center before the this episode started. So Milotic is a I think pure water. I don't think it's water dragon. I think it's pure water. So let's go with Decidueye. Oh, or maybe Raichu. Now, Leaf Blade's pretty good. I mean, if it is Water Dragon, it resists anyway. I think both are similar, and I think Milotic's more likely to have a special defense, but I'm very, very, very much speculating on that. And I do at least resist water, so that's something that maybe I couldn't have taken if I'd have used Raichu there, so... Okay, so they're using Recover, which I think is a complete heal. No, it's not. Good. Oh, Rest is the one that heals them completely, isn't it? And then they go to sleep, so that's fine. Whew, okay. Miss Magius is a ghost, so we want to use Dark, which we don't have, or Ghost, which we do have, actually. Ghost move on Primarina, so we'll go with that. And I think No, I'm wrong. I was going to say, I think Fairy might resist Ghost as well, but I think that's one of those things that I remember wondering if it did, because I was hoping that it might, rather than... Okay, so that was fine because nobody was hit. What Pain Split does is, say like they were on 1 HP and I was full health, we'd both go to 50%. But because we were both on 100 CC, and I'm going to go down in health to match sort of thing. Well, the example I gave was like the one that was easier to understand. I think you just heal by as much as it hurts, sort of thing. Okay, but I don't think we've got a problem with this now. I think we've got it in the bag, so that's good. Is this her last one as well, or she got one more? Beware, fighting type. So let's just keep going. Hope we outspeed, and we can use a Moonblast. Which I think should wipe him out completely. Yep. Sorry, Beware. I think we should do a bit of... I think we should do a bit of grooming to congratulate them on that fight. But I've just realised it's going to, like, really awkwardly now break up a cutscene. Where I've got this, like, epic monster. And it's like, just hold on, please, madam. Because I'm going to wipe the mud off of my Salazzle with this squeaky rag. It's a ShamWow. Buy one now and you get another 4 free. I would feed her a bean, but I feel like we probably shouldn't have even done the cleanup. Oh, I'm shocked. And Lily is like shocked, and Lusamine's like getting eaten alive. I really hope there is official artwork of that for the thumbnail, because it looks amazing. This may be a go on DeviantArt and get somebody's permission to... What's she like doing? Like, eat my mother, please! How did she know that Nebby had the power to do whatever he just did? I mean, he clearly doesn't, because I don't know what... Oh, well, hold on. Don't... Watch before you speak, Dan. Look before you leap. Then the old gummy man insult again. Maybe that's a slight upon myself. Oh, hold on. They've split up. Nintendo is flying away. There's some metaphor in that somewhere. Oh, and she's turned in... Oh, no, she... I thought she turned into something, but I forgot that she'd caught... that it was her Pokemon. Mother! Mother! Oh god, you're still here, Lily! Go away! Oh, all the feels. Sorry, Art, stop doing that. It's just like a filling the dead air. Heh. Is she dead? She dead! Oh no, wait, she's coming back. She's coming back for a boop. She missed. When did you start becoming beautiful? Oh no, she's blind. It's even worse. No, I think she is dead. Would they have death in this game? We'll find out. What now? What's going on? And just when things were getting good, is he still possessed by Nintendo? I don't like how it's clearly like one animation synced up. Now maybe it's meant to be, but it just looks lazy. La la la! Oh no! Oh no! She's still in Cheshire mode. Okay, so I'm not sure what's happening, but I'm not sure you're meant to know what's happening, so it's fine. So we're back. Guzma's been saved. The corpse is here with us. Hapu and Thingy's here with us as well. Find the legend Pokémon Strange Hole in the Sky, however I'm relieved to see you're all unharmed. Hapu is my mother. No, she's moving. There, big fellow. Carry the lady, will you? It's actually you there. You there, big fellow! She's weak, but I don't believe that she's seriously harmed. We should take her to be treated directly.
Huh? Oh. Grr. Huh?
Bit late to be coming up with voices now, Dan. HippoCrisis, you've done well in guiding Lily, though she is not a trainer. And Lily, you gave it your best. We will wait for you down below. Down below, another one for the tally. Everybody drink. How does Hapu know she did her best when she wasn't there? All I ever wanted to do was to help you get back to your own home, but instead you helped me over and over. Thank you. Ah, lovely. Thank you so much. La 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 la. What? What is it? You want to stay with me forever? Shall I guess what you're trying to tell us? He's saying, go away, Lily, is what he's saying. La la Leo. Well, he can come with me, not you. I want him. Smoltz. We met so many people as we travelled around Alola's Islands. Kikui, Burnett, Haller, Hau. Oh yeah, Hau. Poor Hau. He's not been here for a while, has he? I don't belong to you, Lily. And so many other people. And the rest. Name four people and then just... I don't know what the world you came from is like, but Alola is pretty great too. Of course, you want to see it all. Just like Kahuna Hallas told us. You've got to go so many places and meet so many Pokemon and people, and they will enrich your life. La Liona. Ah! That means... No, seriously, go away, Lily. But not with me. I'm not a trainer, Nebby. I can't take you on an adventure. Like, why aren't you a trainer, though? You can just, like... I don't get... What is this, like, I'm not a trainer business? Isn't everybody a trainer? Do you need a license? I guess you do have to actually have a trainer passport in this region, so... Yeah, maybe you do need a license. It doesn't want this journey to end, and I want to grant it this wish. Okay, well... Let's go and talk to it then. La 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 yona! Oh, I have to catch it? If she wants to come with me, just come with me. Look at Lily creeping in the background. Go, Salazzle! Right, so, immediate tactic, of course, is Quick Ball. Oh, I could... No, there's no, I don't think there's any need to Master Ball it. The Master Ball is the thing that you just keep in your... We've got all... Oh no, can we catch them in there? I think we need to catch them in Beast Balls. I was going to say... Oh well, there you go, Quick Ball. If you can learn anything from my series, it's just use Quick Balls. Because, like, level 55 Legendary, Quick Ball, done. Did make it a little less epic, but then again, I feel like if Solgaleo wanted to come with me, he should have just come with me, like their profession. But of course, that's because he was actually saying, go away, Lily, not, please take me with you. Okay, it's said to live in another world. The intense light it radiates from the surface of his body can make the darkest of nights light up like midday. Lovely. No. Now I should add it to my party, really, shouldn't I? Give it a go. So he's Steel Fire, so I guess Salazzle is going. And let's leave that attached to Salazzle, because I annoy myself when I just spam through that one. So what's next? What is next? Shake your head at me. Solgaleo, no. Nebby, you belong to HippoCrisis now. He will be the one to raise you. Just like any parent should raise their child, he will be your father now. Daddy Crisis in the house! I may not have been able to do anything for you, Nebby, so go with HippoCrisis and see the world. Have battles against Pokemon where you can use your full power. Meet other trainers who will make your heart dance with the thrill of it all. What kind of world that HippoCrisis can share with you? If it's you, HippoCrisis, I know I can trust you to raise my Nebby well. Take good care of it, and I will go to my mother. I need to see for myself that she'll be alright. Seriously though, how do I get Cosmog and the other one? Is it Cosmomium or something? Cosmom! Nebby, don't always be trying to get out of your Pokeball. The way you got out of my bag. And don't forget that you're strong now. You'll have to be careful not to accidentally hurt anyone. Lily, I'm sure this is meant to be like really touching. But my disdain for Lily ruins it all. Also my disdain for talking ruins it all. And you can't just go running off to some other world anytime without telling anyone. You'll make HippoCrisis cry. I'm only in danger of crying because you won't be quiet. I'm really going this time. Alola. Don't come back. Don't come back. She's really left. I'll see her again in like 2 minutes. You wait. You just bloody wait. Now what? Now the Ultra Beast popped back out the hole? Oh no, it's Nanu. Cripes, but I hate this place. It's exhausting climbing all the way up here. At least you gave me a good show though. Guess it's worth coming this far, and the prof did ask me and all. Look, once you've completed all your island trials and done the grand trials, then you've got to do one last thing. The final trial. It's a ceremony. You beat all four kahunas in a row. But things are a little different this year, because we're getting a real Pokemon League in Alola 2. Oh, the Elite Four is part of the thing. So what types are they? They're Fighting, Rock, Nanu, and Ground. He's Dark, right? So come to the base of Ulu Islands, Mount Lanakila. Yeah! Yes, I guess I will come with you. Looks like we're making this journey together then. Oh, maybe I should have said no and explored some stuff. So, I think this is where we can finally evolve Crabrawler, so I'm going to go and get him. Let's see what time we're on. Oh, we're good for time, so I don't want to do the Elite Four in this episode, but I do definitely want to heal up if I needed to, which I probably didn't, and to get Crabrawler. Okay. I don't really want to bring Solgaleo, to be honest. I just want to see what he does. So let's bring Crabrawler is there. Let's get rid of Trumby, Toucannon. Okay, let's sit up, let's stretch for the final part of this episode, this epic Pokemon Sun Sunday. So I thought we'd have like another week of episodes, maybe. But we do have post-game stuff, and I haven't done Elite Four yet, so I think I might have been about right. And I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do after. Vladian, I've been waiting for you to thank you for what you did for Lily, for our mother. I appreciate it maybe more than you know, and the only thing I can offer you is a great battle, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to battle you with my Z-Ring. Okay. Well, this is a nice way to end it. Might not be quite what I thought it was going to be, but actually, you know what? I could get a level on thingy from this battle. Okay, so let's Solgaleo. Let's see what I'm super underleveled now. He's got Sunsteel Strike, which is a steel move. Cosmic Power, which is, I believe, a non-damaging. Yep. Zen Headbutt, which is obviously damaging, and Crunch. Let's just use a Sunsteel Strike. Not very effective because I'm steel. Did I just do that thing where I was like, he's not fire, he's psychic steel, so let's get rid of our fire type? Because I should have swapped out Raichu. It's fine though. Let's use Zen Headbutt now, even though I don't think it's very effective. Yep, not very effective at all. And then we'll go with a Crunch, and then we'll never use him again. It feels a little cheaty bringing him to the... Actually, you know what level are the Elite Four? Because I might have to do some grinding beforehand anyway. It's weird because they're usually like level 70 and I'm only pushing 50 on my team. Oh, he did level up, so maybe we can finish on an evolution, which is nice. So who's next? Silvally, which is, I believe, the thing that evolves from type null. So the other thing is, obviously, I can't get given type null either. So I wonder when I get these things, or whether I even can. Maybe they're event things. Dunno. There must be post-game things. So he is weak to fighting, so let's go with... Unless he's been given one of those plates to change his type. Actually, it's probably Silvala, isn't it? Like, okay, so let's go double kick, please, Mudsdale. Oh no, it's not very good at all, and it's not super effective. So he has some sort of thing applied to him that gives him a different type. I wonder if it's the red that's the giveaway. The red on his head. Which, is red fighting, I guess, or is brown fighting? It's this colour. Is it fire, or is it... let's try high horsepower, and if it's fire, then... Well, it'll be super effective. He is a fire type then, I guess. Or is he steel and he just generally steel and that's why it didn't work? I don't know. No, because steel's weak to fighting. I think he was a fire type, but it's hard to tell. Weavile is dark and ice, so actually I need to use, if I can, I need to use double kick again. Ah! No, I don't do that. Double kick, double kick, double kick. Nope. It was worth a try. Okay, so let's go with... he's too puny. Let's go with... Raichu. Don't know why, but we can use Raichu, so... nothing super effective. Let's use a Nuzzle. Okay, that was a mistake. Okay, I can see that now, and I admit it. Situize weak to Primarina. Primarina, please. Oh wait, I've got a super effective move on Primarina, because he's dark. He's weak to Fairy. Didn't think of that, because I'm an idiot. Let's use Mew 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 Moonblast, and add a bonus of not being very effective at all. And also, she's level 50, so this is all working out pretty well. One bang, sweet. Primarina is buffed by the hail. Lucario is fighting steel, so I'm not sure if steel resists fairy, but I can definitely go. Oh, definitely try a moonblast. So it wasn't super effective, because I think steel resists it, but it still did loads, so I'm pleased with that. I don't think it's worth putting in a free switch, but we can do a Twinkle Tackle, because it's his last Pokemon. Oh, he's using his power too. I was just thinking, as I said last Pokemon, he hasn't used his Z-move yet. Corkscrew Crash. Okay, this must be the steel one, because we've not used ours. Okay, so she might faint. Oh well. So who have we got left? Well, if anything, the hail will take him out. Decidueye. Woo-woo! Let's go with a pluck. Strange that steel isn't good against grass, considering that we literally use steel to cut down grass and trees and things. But anyway, that's fine. Okay, so we've defeated Gladion. And we're gonna get the evolve form. I think he's called Crabominable. I think. He's a Yeti crab, which is a real thing. Although they aren't. I don't think they live on icy mountains. There he is. His hands look a bit like bin lids. You know, flip bins. Other than that, he's pretty cool. I mean, he's a bit crackers. He's a bit derpy. He's got boobs. But then again, looking at where he started, he's hardly... he was hardly not derpy to start with. So, it aimed for the top but got lost and ended up on a snowy mountain, being forced to endure the cold. This Pokemon evolved and grew fur. See, this is the exact same, it doesn't make any sense logic that they apply to Sandshrew and Vulpix. Like, why would they just change type rather than dying? Like, it's... I know, I don't care that it's based on real life, natural selection and stuff. This is Pokemon where everything is inherently... inherently element-based, and it just makes no sense to me in-universe, after all these years, that a fire type will move to an icy place and turn into an ice type, which is the polar opposite, pun not intended, but well received. That wasn't me dabbing, but you can take that as my one and only dab. Okay. And Crabominable wants to learn a nice move, I hope? With pleasure, my liege. I don't know why he's my king, but let's get rid of Crab Hammer, because I'm not... let's get rid of Dizzy Punch. Let's get rid of... Is he still fighting? Let's get rid of Brutal Swing. if he still has the thing that apparently doubles punch moves, I don't want to lose a 70 base damage move, because that would be 140. I don't want to learn Iron Defense, though. He keeps trying to learn that, and I don't want him to learn it. So we have Ice in our party now. Now, is anybody in the Elite Four Dragon? They aren't, are they? So that's useless. But there is the Ground Girl, so... Actually, that's a good point. How can she be in the Elite Four when there wasn't a Kahuna, like, 2 minutes ago? Or, like, literally 2 hours ago, like... There's no need to me to exaggerate. So, that's weird. Because how there can't be a champion unless the person who's a champion is literally going in front of me. Okay, so that was Pokemon Sun Sunday, and now it's time to. I guess we're just gonna go straight to the top of the mountain, and I don't know if there's gonna be stuff before the Elite Four, but. I guess we'll find out tomorrow, because we've already done Victory Road, which I think with the thing before. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I've been Dan. You've been awesome. This has been Pokemon Sun. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share the video with your friends. Click on the screen to see some other content right now. Follow me on Twitter at HippoCrisis, and if you want to add me to your friend list, my code is in the description, and don't forget to leave yours in the comments below or I won't be able to add you back. Right, thanks a lot guys, and I'll see you soon for more Pokémon Sun. Bye!